roll killer. Easy now. Anything in here to improve flow. Odd shapes in this port. Probably looks like I'm really hogging on it, but not really taking a whole lot out. Piston check again. getting better, huh? Getting all up in y'all's way. A little bit right there some more. I don't like that. It's pretty even, but I'm not happy with it. Looks like a little bumpy bump. I just need to blend this. That blend this radius here back up in here, because right here is still a ramp right there. I don't want it to be a smooth transition all the way out to the edge. I just want it smirched full because I got a little dippy doo there, so I'll put one here. Cute, makes the OCD feel better, huh? Thank you. looking too bad now. Not bad. Blew two or three chips out. We're gonna call it good. Yep. I think we'll call that okay. Still ain't symmetrical, but good enough for this. I guess I'm not really trying to hit no numbers or nothing. Just horsing around. Alright, tool change. Damn, boxes are about childproof. I want that one. Yep. That ought to fit the radius in there nicely. Oh, and this thing ain't all four to me either. This is just a cheap handle I bought off Amazon. I think it was less than, I don't know, 25 bucks. It might have been a little bit less than 20. It's It's not as smooth as a Fordham handle, but a little noisy, but the main thing is I can hold it better. Little Dremels kind of make my hands tingle after sitting here grinding for a couple hours. Roughing this thing up here, if I'm saying the word correctly, laminar flow. Helps keep the fuel suspended in air. When I get going on the port work on the 288, I'm going to do something a little different than just roughing it up. Don't know whether it's going to yield any major improvements or not, but basically what I'm going to do is take my diamond ball, you know, like this, but it's about an eighth inch or so. Go around and just make dots all through the ports. Well, intake port anyway. We'll find out if it does anything or not anyway. Thank you. can see down in there. Yeah, like I said, this thing was hodgepodged up something terrible. Okay, we are going to at least match that. Yeah, turn that down a click. Right there, down in the bottom there, you can see a ledge. The one over there, we're going to try to get that as close as we can. And we're actually pretty good on the top, not too bad. That's a real pretty sight. The old orange knob there. There we go. Let's see, so. Yeah, right there. So right here, we can open her up a little bit. Let's go ahead and do that. Find my pedal down there. That's getting aggravating. So basically what I'm trying to do is create a tunnel ram effect. Like putting a torquer intake on a 302. Increases velocity. Boy, you can really tell it's getting late at night, huh? Let's see if I can be a retard and do this. Oh yeah, there we go. Can't get much better than that whenever it... ground with it. Yeah, that should be good enough. You gotta pretend to the old Fordham pedals a throttle every once in a while. Huh. just a little more bit. Just a little bit more. Probably about the most retarded thing I've ever done, but seems to be working. Let's see if I can get y'all a peeky peek. That is actually harder than I thought it was going to be. Well, you can barely sneak an eye down in there. Let's try that again. If I can get it in the hole. Ooh. Don't you do it. All right, we're just going to sit it in the lap then. I know, I'm totally out of frame here. That was the easier part. Alright, now to do the off on, off on, and all that good nonsense to get the rest. Give it to me. A little Earl in there. A little bit of Earl. Let's blend this just a little bit. Cut that off. Oh, is that any better? Maybe. Kind of looks like it's been a dot. Fumbling. Oh, I got that time. Then the board actually needs to move on the outside.